dressmaker I deal with, who's old order Amish, has a phone booth on his front lawn by the corner of his road, and he and several of his neighbors pay the cost of a public pay phone at that booth, which has an answering machine, so you can send him a message on his answering machine, and he can call you back on his dime.
So the answering machine is what? One answering machine?
For all of them. The one phone number, one answering machine for all of them. And they can check the message and go, oh, this is his message, this is his message.
Not really know everybody's business, kid.
But none of them are competitors. One's a harness maker, one's a farrier, one's whatever.
So I'm just trying to think of how I am. We could do it on that wooden block. We could forge it out in this little dish. Maybe the wooden block is the way to do it. I'll
get the coal off of it.
Because he's leaving.
Smaller pieces, more of them, and end up with pieces that fit, just because this is a little harder to manipulate. So I want to continue that through to the edges. And I could probably do that here again. Although that's not the best. Maybe I'll use that wooden block. I'll get one more heat, get it enough raised in the middle of the whole thing, and then maybe true it up from here.
You want to put that wooden block on the rice table?
It would be the best place right here. You ever notice there's not enough horizontal spaces in your shots?
So true.
Yeah, I know, but you can tag it that way.
No way.
You never have enough places to work.
Now, I'll just throw in one thing on this. Yeah. I've gotten to, on my anvil, I've got a little block of hardwood, about so by so, that's the length of the anvil, and then I put square tubing in, is the size of the hearty hole, and then cut it and bend it over a little bit, and put it in the wood, and if it pushes it up, it'll go flat. Maybe it'll get it. And then there's little shapes in the outside of that.
That's good. So, I have a raised section in the center, and it's relatively smooth in here. I'm going to get a smaller hammer and do it in here.
It gives us so much more life with that raising.
Yeah.
It does, and it, you know, the surprising thing is, it's the same as the shape of a gate, you know. You can have a square top, and you put scrolls on the ends. A little bit of a rise. It doesn't have to be a huge thing, just a little curve, that's all it takes. And you've got that softer line.
Well, nature doesn't have straight lines.
That's right. So maybe I'll use that little pocket. Did it work?
Thank you.
said, whatever works, use. That's got a bit of a rise, you can see. A little lumpy, but it'll probably work. The challenge, and that's the reason you make so many of them, is to make two that are going to kind of fit together. So take another one of those.
Have you made those up for a specific project?
These are leftover pieces from that job in Burlington that I did with the large fleur-de-lis all across the front of the place. I think there's only one fleur-de-lis in each section kind of thing, and it was mounted. I cut the pickets and mounted this on the side, kind of like that one that's out there. Mm-hmm. That was maybe the prototype, and it was too hard, too busy, too heavy looking. This way, I thought I could get a nice clean look, and it was lighter. I could still galvanize it all, and it was just, I'd rather do this than forge that heavy plate. Mm-hmm. So we're going to raise this one.
Okay.
You're going to cheat.
A little bit of a curve in there to grab the black steel.
It's actually designed for some of this this half inch. That's what it was for. That's what I bought it for. That was one of the few.
Off-center?
Off-center for the drape. So that captures that quite nicely. I've worn it back almost too much now, but it still holds sheet steel quite nicely. You can see that groove.
So it's nice on flats. Just noting it with interest. Oh, close. Point it out to you guys here back there.
Now, I want.
Is it reverse?
Looks like we're doing this the right way. Remember all those books, those Kosyra books? You ever, those, the Forge?
Yeah, I got a few.
They're all now online.
Yeah, are they?
Yeah. You can download them.
I've got a couple of them here.
Which books are these?
Kosyra. The British ones?
Yeah. So it's Kosyra, and they're all available online. Yeah. They're really good books.
Small industrial in rural areas.
Yeah.
What was that, Jim?
Council.
Yeah.
Council of Small Industries in Rural
exactly.
Areas.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Those Mark Asprey books aren't cheap, eh?
These ones are.
No, but they're similar to those.
Yeah, they're good things.
I got the big one of all the gate packs.
All right. Yeah.
And the one of weather vanes.
Yeah, I downloaded those for free off the net.
You used to be able to send off from and get the full size sheets.
Full size, yeah. Line, yeah. Anyway, every second line in there is take another heat.
Yeah.
You don't know that?
Yeah.
Forge something. Take another heat.